When I first saw the announcement for Threads in Microsoft Teams, I was like, how is this any different than what we already have? It wasn't until they released the feature that I understood what they were trying to do. So to get started, I've logged into my demonstration account for Teams, and we're looking at a classic post-style channel where somebody can create a message, and then when another person replies, the messages are all kept together, and this has traditionally been called threading. So to look at the difference, we're going to look at a different channel where the thread layout has been applied, and instead of the tab being called posts, it's called conversations. When people begin to create messages, it's going to look more like a chat where your message has a light purple background and it's adjusted towards the right side of the screen, and other people's messages will have a gray background and it's adjusted to the left side of the screen. Unlike chat, what you can do is hover over the message and click this two bubble icon to reply in thread, and it's going to open up a pane on the right-hand side of the screen where you can keep all of the responses together. And then once the first person responds, you'll see a little reply option just below the original message to make it easier for the next people to respond. One tip that I would like to point out is that the subject line for the threads is hidden behind the formatting options. Unlike a post, when you start the message, the subject line is right at the top, helping you organize your content much easier. So if you're in the thread layout, click on the little A with a pencil, and then you're going to see that option. So for example, if I create a new thread and I say, what's new on the roadmap, it's going to be easier for the other team members to identify the messages that they want to interact with. So now that we see that Adele has replied to my roadmap message, I can simply click on that thread to update what I'm seeing in the threads pane on the right-hand side of the screen. So basically what's happening is in the conversation section of the channel, you're seeing the original messages, and then when you select one, you'll see all of the replies in the thread pane. Now there's another way that you can look at the different threads. Every time that you create a message or respond to one, you're automatically going to be following it. So I want to draw your attention to the navigation pane on the left-hand side of the screen. And this is where you will see the option for follow threads in the filter section at the top. When you select that, there will be a view that shows just the threads that you're following across the various teams and channels that you belong to, even if those channels are in the traditional post style. By default, this will be filtered by unread, and then you can click through the different messages to catch up on what you might have missed. So in this example, Adele is telling me that 90% of the roadmap items were about Copilot, specifically about PowerPoint. So I'm going to ask her whether or not I should update some training. Now you can create these replies right here from the followed threads pane, or I can go up to the right-hand side of the screen and click go to channel and create my reply there. Either way, it's still going to show up. But then I am in the channel so I can look at everything else that's going on in this team. Now, one of the things that I would like to point out is when you create a brand new channel, the thread layout is going to be the default. You can select posts if you prefer. Now, speaking of preferences, channels that were created before the threads feature was released are still going to be in the classic post layout. If you prefer the threads layout, you can switch it. Hover your mouse over the name of the channel you want to change and then select the three dots for more options. From the menu that appears, choose Edit Channel. A dialog box is going to pop up, and all you need to do is check the radio button for threads and click Save. You would use this exact same menu path if you are in a threads layout and you prefer the post layout. The only difference is where you put your radio button. So I'm a bit on the fence about whether or not I like this new thread style, because here's what I'm seeing. This looks like a chat and people are treating it like chat, where they just click in the box at the bottom of the screen and they respond to a message. without actually attaching it to the original comment. So then you have all of these back and forth messages that aren't really tied together, and the conversations just become a bit of chaos. Now, if you like the threaded style, what I would suggest is making sure everybody on your team knows how to properly reply to messages to tame the chaos, and just do a little bit of education with your team members.